What is going on, everybody? It's Crazy Man here, bringing you guys a lengthy 2v2 today. This is on the map Biffy's Peril Redux. I wanted to make sure I didn't screw that up. And he says he hates this map already. I actually want to talk about that. before we introduce the players, a lot of people don't play the new maps, and I don't know why. Maybe one of you guys can answer this. They just don't. I mean, I played against Caldute. He's actually in this game. I don't know. Is he the only one posting games or something? But yeah, he's he didn't want to play on the new maps because I actually had one of the new maps set up in my 1v1 with him. But now we're gonna get to the players. Man and Mars. I don't know. Spawning is the Lord General in the upper top position here. True example spawning in on the left, west. I don't know. I think it's west. West position is the Hive Tyrant, and down here on the bottom we have TG0 spawning in as the Chaos Sorcerer, and over here on the right we have Caldute spawning in as his Tech Marine, probably his favorite race. After seeing him play with me as the Tech Marine with the Tech Marine, and he's playing him again. I don't think that's a coincidence, but. Here we go, red team getting off to a quick start in terms of the victory points. They already have two of them down. He does have the power stomp, ground pound on the Sentinel, and is he? Oh, a big stomp right there, barely missing off the scouts though, as the scouts are charging and they are going to engage in melee combat. Very good use right there by Man on Mars to to repair instead of actually attacking these guys in melee, and these scouts are going to take a bunch of damage. They're calling out Bot MIA. What is this, Dota League? Come on, man. You don't need to call out Bot MIA. But whoa, there goes a big Chaos Bolt. Nearly able to do a ton of damage right there. That would have been very, very bad. He actually draws at the Tech Marine, and they may get the kill. Oh, he's going to back off there. As here come the Nids. Oh, God. The Nids. There goes the suppression off on the Chaos Heretics. As he is getting the Aspiring Champion. Will he finish in time? No, he does not. Oh, he does. And that actually saves the squad right there from dying. Do have the rendering talons. Rending talons on the Hive Tyrant already completed. Very unusual upgrade. I wouldn't actually recommend getting the rending talons because of the fact that the crushing claws are far superior against vehicles. And Devast is short for Devastator. I like the blue team right now. They have a lot of communication going on between the two players. I don't know if they're friends. I don't know what the deal is going on with them, but Kachkin's already completed for our guardsman player, and I like this because everyone's a different race. And it makes no sense their combinations. Like, you guys would never partner up with the Tyranids because you don't even speak the same. I don't even know what language. I don't even think they speak his language. I think they just kind of blob. And then Chaos would obviously never partner up with Space Marines, but this Chaos Sorcerer taking a bit of damage. He's going to be forced to retreat. Not too much of a fight there. And True Example going all out on his Hive Tyrant here, early Tier 1. Really should be interesting to see what he does with that, and if he does actually upgrade. Meanwhile, the scouts. Oh, if he could pick them off! Oh! Oh, they escape. Wait. Nope, not. No, they got away. But, does not look like a winning fight for the Space Marine down here. We're going to rejoin the battle on another Devastator team. However, the Hive Tyrant, if he was actually paying attention, I'm not sure if he is paying attention, he would simply walk his Hive Tyrant right through the suppression team and would free up his units. And there he goes. Now he's starting to attack with his Hive Tyrant. And he's got some pretty decent upgrades on that Hive Tyrant already. And that should be a major force. The Hive Tyrant, one of the best commanders in the game in terms of just raw strength, and if you can get levels on him, he's going to be so devastating. And although this is not good for TG0, he is probably going to lose both of his squads, and they will both go down. There he goes. Oh, never mind. Big plays there by the Pathic. So here comes a flare. That is not a flare. That is a missile. Cool. Missiles are cool. But Nid player, was able to take him down. However, he sustained... Oh, that was the artillery spotter squad. My bad. I didn't even notice them that called that in. The new units for the guardsmen. So, warriors on the way for Kaldut. We got some heretics already on the way again for TG0. Must have lost his other squad. And, yeah, not a whole lot happening right now. I'm interested to see these artillery spotters units. They're rather squishy in terms of HP. I don't know what their attack is. It is just called on missiles. Okay, that's pretty cool. I'm a fan of missiles and explosions. And that is going to be really effective against this devastated marine squad. Not sure what... Oh, he's talking about his hive tyrant won't capture the point. Maybe that's a bug, maybe that's a glitch. I don't know. Requeet? Yes, requeet! But more warriors on the way. Four true example, and warriors are a big, big player in Elite Mod. They've always been a big unit. Chaos Raptors on the way. Still don't like their icon, by the way. I just thought I'd point that out. It looks like they have no head. But Red Team coming up big here in the early parts of this game. They're just taking over. However, they're investing a ton in Tier 1. I feel like Kaldut needs to just save up, and both of them actually need to save up and probably just buy some, buy themselves a Tier 2 upgrade. As, whoa, there goes a big... the big grenades and the Doom Bolt completely missed by TG0. He needs to be careful here not to lose his commander, and he will go down. That was a big snipe right there by this squad, and they contain, these guardsmen have a lot of damage, but here come the Tyranids! Oh, he's got Barb Strangler, and he's got some warrior upgrades as well. Is these Chaos Heretics not gonna last very long, but the red team has been thwarted back. As here comes the Hive Tyrant. Oh no, the Hive Tyrant! Oh, gets the suppression off, but here comes the Chaos Raptors! Are they Raptors? Good, okay. I was gonna say Havocs for some reason again. But that is... that may not have been the best choice simply because of the suppression and all of the Tyranid melee that is out on the field. It would be a good choice against Guardsmen, though. But unfortunately for him, that's not exactly the player he's up against directly. As there goes a smoke screen. And there goes a nice nade, and you have... a sergeant. He changed the sergeant icon. I actually didn't notice that till just now. He looks like a... I don't know. He looks kind of weird. Whatever. But the Devastator squad trying to get set up, and here comes an artillery strike. Boom! There it goes. Gonna not let them get that suppression down. And then, what are you shooting at, guy? Just wasted your catch against fires right there. But this suppression team will get set up, or will they? Will they? Oh, they got set up. Okay. And they're actually going to retreat right away. That's a questionable decision. But here drops a nade on himself. I love that! Oh! God, dropping grenades on yourself. Best ability for scouts. Even though it's not an ability, they have to... that's something you, the player, do. But getting some experience from taking out these nodes. I feel like the turn to play... actually, most players go in Tier 2. And Kaldut is already Tier 2. So, he should have an early advantage here. They do have a pretty comfortable lead on the scoreboard. But they're going in for the power once again. I think this is a mistake by them. As Manomars is preparing to call in a bunker in the middle. And that will not be good for the red team at all. I mean, they do have their Tech Marine. He's actually trying to revive... there's the sergeant, Stern Guard veteran. I keep thinking that's sergeant for some reason. There is a Stern Guard veteran squad being summoned in, but this is definitely a losing battle for the red team as they are forced back. Should be seeing a bunker here relatively soon as there goes a flame strike, but kind of missed everything. I mean, if he would have called in a little bit more to the north, he would have hit them. If he would have the guardsmen, if he would have called in a little more to the south, he would have hit the Nids. But actually, he called it pretty much right in the middle, to where they both missed. But this artillery spotter squad, he needs to keep these guys alive. Oh, they're down to just 1 of 3, and actually gonna force the retreat on the heretics. Is he gonna kill them off? Yes. No. Yes. No. They get away with 3 HP. The aspiring champion flees for his life as the Tyranids are showing absolutely no mercy, and he's actually going to lose his Hormigaunts. No, he will not. Okay. A little bit early on that one. But here comes the bunker. Oh, I don't know if that placement is the right placement. I probably would have put it over here. Or here, or here. I understand he wants to protect the power and all that stuff. That's good stuff. I don't mind that. But at the same token, you want them to be an effective force, as they are doing Nurgle damage, splash damage, and they are picking off these guardsmen very quickly. As the Chaos Raptors jumping in, these guys are going to hop on this building, and I'm not sure if he upgraded it to be a healing bunker or not. There he goes. It is now a reinforceable bunker. Power on this map is painful. Well, nobody has that node down there, but his Zonthrope is on the way. Zonthrope, however you want to say it, is this Chaos Sorcerer. He's trying to tank it out. He's trying so hard. Oh, he actually has two Zonthropes now. There goes the grenade. Come middle with an exclamation point. With the exclamation point, folks. The artillery spotter does get set up. There's a pretty nice artillery strike right there. Going to do a lot of knockback. I've noticed that that doesn't exactly do a ton of damage, but it does do very good knockback, which is excellent against suppression teams and Devastator Plasma Cannon teams alike. But I kind of feel sorry for Mr. Guardsman. He just had to fight a 2v1 by himself. And that's never a good situation to be in. As the tier of the player kind of was a little slow in reacting and helping his teammate out there. But the Tech Marine, and he's pretty much here to just clean everything up. Still no Crushing Claws on these guys yet, so this Chaos Dreadnought will do pretty good work. Meanwhile, Kaldoot is going just straight tier 3 rush. He did build a couple tier 2 units, though. But he's got a suppression team covering his Devastator Plasma Cannon team. That's not going to be too effective, especially against the Zonthropes, which in fact do outrange them. Here comes the Guardsman artillery strike. Oh, just missing them by about a second or two. So we do have shotguns on the way. But they are down in the victory point department. As you see, a pretty comfortable 200-point lead for the red team. As they are starting to wonder if his description of the replay lied a little bit. But I'm going to hold my thoughts here. As he does have anti-vehicle actually on his warriors, and the Zonthrope supplying pretty good pressure as well. Missed the jump right there with the Chaos Raptors. They will probably now get suppressed, and this Hive Tyrant just tanking it up. You don't actually want to shoot that Hive Tyrant. That's just not a good idea at all, but these Tyranids are going to be forced to back out. Meanwhile, Space Marines are trying to fight the Guardsmen in a rather interesting battle. These Guardsmen do have plasma guns, however these do not, and it looks like these Guardsmen are actually we're very close to dying there. You do not want to toy with Space Marines, but there's an artillery strike that actually did nothing. And these guys are facing the wrong way. Hive coming. Hive Tyrant Guard. I'm not sure why he said Hive. Maybe he meant Hive Tyrant, but they're just Tyrant Guard. I don't know. Anyway, losing his Hormigaunts, I think those are. They're either Hermogons or Tormogons. I get the two mixed up all the time. But he's getting his artillery spotter strike squad positioned and ready to get called in. I hear some Mark of Zinch coming, and there it is. Mark of Zinch is probably the correct choice considering axes against this army while devastating against the Zonthropes. Not exactly a good idea with the Hive Tyrant and the other warrior brood. Very capable of tanking them out, as this capillary tower is going to be destroyed. When I look at the word capillary, I always think of caterpillar. I'm not gonna lie, but sniper rifle on the way, without a doubt his best attachment against Space Marines and Chaos Space Marines alike, so that will be a very welcome addition to him, I'm sure. Still no, oh my god, he's got three warrior broods now, all of them with great melee, as the Zonthropes are doing work, son. Doing work. Warriors pouncing on these units. Will they kill off these Space Marines? Yes, they will. Here come the Heretics, and they immediately get blasted by the Zonthropes. Will they make it out? Yes, it seems they will at least have the luxury of escaping, but this Chaos Dreadnought will probably die. As there goes a nice flame strike. He retreats with all of his units, except for the Hive Tyrant. I think one of his squads probably could have stayed in there a little bit longer and tanked it out a bit more, but the Chaos Dreadnought actually getting away is, oh my god, these Zoanthropes are tearing apart the Space Marine and Chaos armies, as they have runs this dangerously low on forces. Not sure a Predator tank is what you want to get here. I'd actually like to see him save up for Terminators, as he probably could have called those in. Would have been the much better choice. But nonetheless, they need to do something, because these Zoanthropes are tearing apart their army with the Tyrant Guard out. They do need some anti-vehicle as well, as the extra armor is on the way. I do like that he's going straight for the Guardsman. The Guardsman player does not have a lot of anti-vehicle. I believe he doesn't actually have any, with the exception of these Kachkins, who probably don't have all their upgrades. But a Sniper is not too effective against Predator tanks. Does have a Stormtrooper squad on the way, so he went straight for the Tier 3 Rush, but it's not paying off for him thus far, and still no upgrades on this Chaos Dreadnought. Would be a good idea to go ahead and get himself a missile launcher there. Great for AoE, and it's solid against vehicles as well, which this Tyranid player has plenty of. And the Guardsman has a ton of, would be for the infantry part of that, but blue team is starting to catch back up. Bad idea announces true example with the Predator tank, as he is just going to chase this down, and there was a very nice shot by the Devastator Plasma Cannon team, but they don't care. They just do not care. This Predator tank is trying to take through it. Here come the Chaos Raptors, and this is looking like a really good battle, really winnable battle for the red team, as they are getting levels up left and right, killing off these warrior squads, members of the warrior squads at least. There's another big knockback, and he's going to be able to kill off one of these squads if he focuses them. Focus them. Oh, they are dead. Okay. This Tyrant Guard just doing too much tanking, though. Oh, wait, no, they are still alive with 26 HP. But here come the Guardsmen, and they are going to ruin everything that the team of red had going on. And he's just going to sit here and tank it out, because that's what the Tyrant Guard does. However, this is not a very acceptable tanking idea, but this Hive Tyrant, level 5, he's also beasting it up. Here comes the Meltaguns, and this suppression team has been standing back here the whole time. They're having a huge impact. They're just getting levels left and right. Finally, here comes the missile, and smoke grenade. These guys are level 3 already. And Come On Man is announced. Come on, man. As this Chaos Knight is just sitting there shooting. I almost said shitting there for a second. Sitting there shooting the Tyrant Guard, which is not what you want to do with that. You want to be targeting these Kachkins or something, as the suppression team gets set up once again, and they are going to suppress the Guardsmen, and actually forcing the retreat there. But the Tyrant player is back. He didn't repair or reinforce his one squad, so he's going straight for this Chaos Dreadnought. Not sure how that'll work, considering his warrior squads are damaged. He's lost one of them already, but this Tyrant Guard was able to survive all that impressively enough. And this cannon, not put in a good position. You probably want to put it up here on, actually right next to the victory point, if you do choose to call in a cannon at this location, mainly because he can't hit anything. He can't shoot upstairs or anything, so. Chaos Dreadnought charging in again, only to retreat again, and this time he may not actually live. He does escape, okay. Needs to be targeting the Tyrant Guard with this. And there he does actually shoot it for a second there. So now these guys are just, that's just a form of execution, man. Oh, they do have lightning claws as well. But here's some Chaos Terminators called in. Khaldun needs to get himself a pair of Terminators as well, and I think they'll be set to lock this game down. They only have a 100-point victory point lead, so it's not looking too good for them right now, as he's misusing his Chaos Terminators. You don't want to just send them in alone, which is what they're doing right now. But Space Marine play is actually doing work against these all their infantry. Meanwhile, the Terminators just teleporting on out there, and that was not exactly the best use of Chaos Terminators right there. As losing two members, they're expensive as well, so not exactly the best choice of units or best way to use those units right there. We do have an orbital strike, however, it pretty much missed. I guess you could watch from afar here. Whoa! But let's go back to the actual game camp. So the suppression team, this suppression team, regardless of his team wins or loses, has been the MVP of this game. They've just stood here, and they've done their job of suppressing. Not to mention there's a Devastator cannon team right there, hidden in the generators. And there goes another big shot, and it looks like finally... Whoa, there goes a Warrior Squad. Whoa! But this Warrior Squad may go down. There goes another one. Why are they flying in the air like that? And if he shoots them, shoot them. Oh! 29 HP is what they escape with. And the Zonthropes just tear apart that Chaos Heretic Squad. My goodness. So what do we have going on down here? The Hive Tyrant just tanking. He has two Hive Tyrants now. We'll shift back to this squad viewer. As Chaos Terminators are being reinforced, he does have the autocannon on them. Which is a good choice. You don't need any more suppression. Kaldut's his Devastator's suppression team has just been doing work all day. So he's going to have really good anti-vehicle capabilities, as this Tyrant Guard is going to try and tank through all of this. Meanwhile, Land Raider on the way from Kaldut. Excellent choice right there. Instead of the Chaos Terminators, now you have to respect both. And for some reason, he's punching this. Respect both the enemy's Terminators as well as their Land Raider. Two Uber units is better than one, but... not sure what he's actually firing that shot at. Meanwhile, that turret was destroyed as well as the bunker. So this artillery spotter squad is still alive. And they do get a nice artillery spotter shot. He's very uncoordinated because that was actually both of his units calling that in. So this Chaos Raptor is still alive, still doing pretty good, I guess. But they're taking a lot of damage now, and they're probably going to want to retreat sometime relatively soon. As the Hive Tyrant is just tearing them to pieces, and it looks like they should escape. Oh no! Oh no! Oh! Oh, he's gonna get away. Oh no, he doesn't! As he face plants there right at the end, as the Chaos Terminus have been sitting here pounding away at this Tyrant Guard for what seems like forever. And will they finally get to kill it? Kill the Tyrant Guard! It's level 3, and there it goes. Level 3 Tyrant Guard finally goes down, but he has another one right there. And uh-oh. Just having enough energy to use his anti-vehicle, and there goes the Predator tank, seemingly, as it is slowly backing away. Slowly. And he's actually pinned in by his own teammate. But actually going to force the retreat there. Killing off that Stormtrooper squad that actually took them out. And he may very well take out this Tyrant Guard as well! Oh! Big plays! So our Chaos player has no army. As, neither does the Guardsman. Guardsman player is very low on units. Tyrant player has 3 Zonthropes. I'm not sure why, I think 2 is plenty. But... it was a big play right there. Chaos Predator on the way. And Manonanners, he's still tier 2. He needs to get himself beefed up. But he's about to find out the Land Raider is a mean mofo. Is Kaldut's trying to convince him he's got 40 HP, and he actually does. I thought he had 10 for a second there as well, but... but he is going to focus this Land Raider down with so much anti-vehicle. The flames are doing a bunch of damage, but he has no support for them. And now he's just going to start making use of the guns. And such as this guy has a lot of HP regen. A lot of HP regen. But these Chaos Termies should do just fine against these Guardsmen. Is this Tech Marine? He's level 8. Checking out all the commanders here. We still have no war gear on the Chaos Sorcerer, missing out on opportunities there. Lord General does have his sniper and some armor, which allows him to heal his infantry. He's level 5, and the Hive Tyrant has all of his stuff. Rending Talons, Improved Synops, Psychic Scream. All sorts of good, but this game is very close. 160 to 176 on the scoreboard as they are going in. Oh, what are they going to shoot? They're shooting the Tech Marine for some odd reason. Not sure that's the correct thing to shoot, but this Chaos Predator just charged right. Whoa, why did you go flinging back 100 feet? The warriors are killed off. And they are shooting down these capillary towers. Meanwhile, Hive Tyrant taking a bunch of damage and actually gonna lose the Hive Tyrant as well. Oh! Down it goes! Oh, yeah, she started shooting something else. Apparently, the capillary towers are more important than killing off your opponent's super god commando guy. As he's reinforcing via the battlefield thanks to the Land Raider, which is just its presence being there alone is huge, because he can just sit there, heal up, reinforce. The Tyranids have to go back to base. Guardsmen have to go back to base. These guys just fell back to the Land Raider. That's all you gotta do. But things definitely not looking good for the blue team. Is hold on here, where did this Lord General come from? Is now he's in a bit of trouble. That's not the position you want to be in when you're using a sniper. But here comes an artillery strike. Oh my god! Is it gonna kill off the Chaos Termies? Actually, he does die off, but this middle of the battlefield, man, just look at this battlefield. There's charred everything. Everywhere is a Lehman Rustic. Oh! Sniping out the Chaos Sorcerer. Oh, man. As this Chaos Predator is getting healed up, they have a lot of tanks, but that comes at a high, a lot of vehicles, actually, in general, but they need a high, or they have a high repair cost, and these guys are just not repair cost, but high need for repairs, and these scouts are, they are so busy. As he's gonna be spamming Venom Broods, he says, but he is actually building a Carnifex, which, don't get me wrong, Carnifex is excellent against are those all dead guys? Yes they are. Okay, that's kind of depressing. As we do have an upgrade on the Lehman Russ, Elite Tank Crew, which is permanently increases the vehicle's health and sight radius by 15. As this Tech Marine gonna actually rev his teammate. He's level 10. This is the first game I've seen in a long time where we have a level 10 champion, hero, whatever you wanna call it, commander. That's what it is. But time is running out on the blue team. They're down to 100 victory points. It's 100 to 155. As Carnifex is out, he does have the Venom Cannon on the way. He has the Venom Brood on the way as well. And all these tanks are getting healed up. Healed up. Lehman Russ tank is out as well. I'm surprised he doesn't have another upgrade on that. Meanwhile, Chaos Havoc's on the way for your Chaos player. As there, the Hive Tyrant actually has been countered fairly effectively versus this Devastator Plasma Cannon team. As the Guardsman player is not waiting any longer. He wants to go in now. He's down to just 80 victory points there on that team. As the zone throws, whoa, encountering some lag here. Maybe I'll turn down my settings, I don't know. But all the anti-vehicles actually shooting those poor Devastator Cannon squad guys, and they do die off rather quickly. As here we go, Flamestrike dropped. Here goes the Uber Chaos Power right on top of the right on top of them, and that's gonna kill off one Zonthrope. Gonna kill off the Hive Tyrant as well, as he runs right through it. Or will it? Oh no, he's actually gonna tank through just fine. Bravo, my good sir. Bravo. As this Carnifex is forced to retreat, however, in the midst, they were able to capture this victory point. But the bunker goes down. Is not looking good for the blue team. They just cannot seem to get a beat on this red team, who is just all over the map right now, dominating with their vehicles, their tanks, their Terminators as well. But these guys are getting quickly focused down here. That's a lot of stuff. And here comes Orbital Bombardment! And it picks up all the Venom Broods! Oh no! And they're forced to stand in the fire as well. And there goes so many Venom Broods. The Carnifex goes down as well. As True Example is not happy. Not happy at all. And Karn was nowhere near. It was actually right there in the explosion radius. And that would kill it. As once again blaming the map. As artillery squad. doing work. As it seems this will be game. Too many resources for the guardsmen. Or not the guardsmen, excuse me, the space marine. Left over. Even if they were to make some attempt at a comeback, they would fall short. As, I gotta lie. Or I gotta tell you something. I gotta lie. The game description lied. It said that TG0 lost. Well, here he is. I shouldn't say the game is over yet. But certainly leading in that direction. As this Chaos Wizard, I'm surprised you did not upgrade him at all. Oh, he actually did get an upgrade now. He got the teleporty armor. Sounds like something you would see orcs having, but down to just 10 victory points. This was a solid 2v2 nonetheless. Just looking at the battlefield, you could tell that there was really battles everywhere, which is why I love this map. Love these new maps, because they are just so middle focused, so middle oriented, as the tank goes down, but the flamers running in and burning all the nids, purifying the Xenos. There you go. Definitely not as much action up here. There's a lot of dead guardsmen, but you're gonna have that anywhere. So, a couple dead chaos guys right there. Let's see some space. There are some space marines mixed in with guardsmen. Really like that he added that back in. Persistent death to units. It's a really cool option, really cool feature in the Elite mod as well. But that's it. Let's go check out some of the stats, because this is a super long video, as it is. And I'm interested to see how things played out for both teams. I'm going to guess the Space Marine did get the Champion Award, though, because he played very well that game. That Devastator Marine Squad, man, they just locked it down for, like, the whole game. It was just... You know exactly where I'm talking about, as he did get that. The Commander score very high on almost everyone except TG0, who did not get any upgrades. So, hope you learned a lesson, valuable kitties, here today. Get upgrades on your commander, he'll pay it off. Unit score was very high again. I do agree that Tour Example did have a very high unit score, as lots of units were lost, especially by the guardsmen, which is to be expected. Oddly enough, though, he did have the most resources, almost nearing 9,000, almost totaling 9,000 requisition. That's a ton of requisition. I don't care if you're guardsmen or not, you could just spam guardsmen for days and you'd be okay with that. Guardsmen and stormtroopers, man. OP. But, Kaldut winning the victory point. Obviously, you expected that to happen with these guys, considering they're getting a 149 boost in that. But I hope you guys enjoyed. It was a very solid 2v2. Lots of action in the middle of the map. I'm out. See ya.